Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Mridul and I am part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this video, we will learn about ESP-NOW. Earlier, when we wanted to transfer data from one ESP32 board to another wirelessly, we had options like connecting the boards to a common Wi-Fi network or creating a client-server network between the boards. However, now Espressif Systems have developed a wireless peer-to-peer communication protocol named ESP-NOW for ESP boards. In a peer-to-peer network, each node can act as a server for other nodes, allowing data transmission across the nodes without needing a central server. ESP-NOW requires the pairing of the devices before the communication, but after the pairing is done, the connection is safe for data transmission through a peer-to-peer network without the need for handshakes. Thus, ESP-NOW is a fast communication technology featuring short package transmission where multiple devices can exchange data simultaneously. Apart from being fast, ESP-NOW also provides security as it applies the IEEE802.11 Action Vendor Frame technology, the IE function, and the CCMP encryption technology, providing a secure communication solution. The supported ways of communication offered by ESP-NOW are one-way communication and two-way communication. One-way communication can be of three types. These three types are 1. One slave board sending data to one master board. 2. Multiple slave boards sending data to one master board. 3. One slave board receiving data from multiple master boards. On the other hand, two-way communication has only one type, and that is multiple boards sending and receiving data from each other. In this case, there is no defined master and slave boards. The ESP-NOW technology has removed the need for a local network for devices to communicate. Apart from this, ESP-NOW has other advantages as well. These advantages include 1. It provides both encrypted and unencrypted unicast communication between devices. 2. It supports mixed encryption and unencrypted peer devices. 3. One-time data transmission can be up to 250 bytes. 4. The sending callback function returns the transmission status, that is success or failure, to the application layer. However, ESP-NOW has some limitations as well. The limitations are 1. Data broadcasting is not supported, that is, the data can only be sent to one MAC address or device. 2. The total number of peers should be less than 20, which includes encrypted and unencrypted peers. 3. Data above 250 bytes cannot be sent in one go. Any ESP-NOW enabled device have roles of its own, and these roles are of 4 different types, which are 1. Idle, when the data transmission for that board is not allowed. 2. Controller, in this role, priority is given to the station interface. 3. Slave, in this role, priority is given to the soft AP interface. 4. Combo, in this role, the board is in soft AP plus station interface, as the role can be a controller or a slave. Let us now understand the steps for sending or receiving payload using ESP-NOW. The steps are as follows. 1. Set sending callback function. This function can be used to tell whether the transmission was successful or failure. 2. Set receiving callback function. This function can inform the application layer that the packet sent by the peer has been received. This function also returns the MAC address of the peer and the payload. 3. Calling the API. If the key needs to be encrypted, the API that sets PMK can be called for configuration. If PMK is not configured, then the default PMK will be used. If you want to know more about PMK, please check out the link in the description. 4. Set the communication interface for the devices. The station interface defines a role that can be an idle, controller, slave, or combo. 5. Select the same key for all devices. This is used to decrypt the encrypted payloads by assigning the same encrypted key to all the peers. This function is also called for adding a new peer. 6. Call the sending function to return the payload. If the sending function returns a specific MAC address, the payload will be sent to the assigned address. However, if the sending function returns null, the payload will be sent to all the associated peers. This network congestion may result in network delay or sometimes transmission failure as well. If you want to learn more about ESP-NOW, check out the video's description. In the next video, we will implement the ESP-NOW protocol for transmitting data. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.